Hello friends, welcome to UGC EPG Pathshala. I'm Atika Tajdar from Department of Geography, Jamia Millia Islamia. I'm presenting this module on behalf of Dr. Deeksha Bajpayee. In this module, we'll have some understanding of urban hierarchy, primate city and rank size rule. The concept of urban system was introduced by Brian J.L. Berry in 1964. In his noteworthy work, Cities as Systems Within Systems of Cities. Urban places do not exist in isolation. There is a whole series of different type of relationship between separate town and cities, and we use the term urban system to indicate that the individual urban center are linked to each other. The urban centers play a significant role in social and economic transformation and geographic shift of population. With the increase of population globally, towns and cities have become magnet of economic, social and political processes. At national level, cities are part of a complex system of interrelated urban places and the key element in economic, social and political organization of regions and nation. The interdependence among towns and cities makes it important to view a country as a system of urban place rather than as a series of independent settlement. Urban system is defined as any network of interdependent urban places. The nature of interdependent urban places. The nature of interdependence among urban places may be economic, political, social, or cultural. In the system of cities, the changes taking place in one city, such as population, economy, employment, structure, etc., will have consequences on other cities in the system. The idea of urban hierarchy is central to the concept of urban system. The urban hierarchy concept considers that the urban places vary in population sizes and economic functions. The analysis of urban hierarchy mainly relate to the ranked order of cities based on different criteria such as population size, economic power, retail sales and number of industrial workers. The concept of primate city. The law of the primate city is one of the most basic generalization regarding the size distribution of cities introduced by M. Jefferson. The law is established on agglomeration effect by which a city over and over the capital city grows inexplicably to outshine the rest. The law, a country's most important city is always disproportionately large and remarkably expressive of nation capacity and feeling. It exerts supremacy on all other, not only in population size but also in its role as a political, economic and social center for the country. Examples are following. London, which is 7 times that of Liverpool, Copenhagen, 9 times that of Arras, Mexico City, 5 times that of Guadalajara. Jefferson made a study of 51 countries where he found that in 28 instances, the primate city was over twice the size of the second largest city and in 18 instances, it was more than 3 times. Factor affecting primacy. Attempts were made by Linsky to classify is more accurate term the factor probable to produce an elevated degree of primacy or tough domination by the primate city. He further demonstrated that countries with an elevated level of primacy have a tendency to exhibit the subsequent characteristics. First is small territorial extent. Second is relatively high population density. Third is low per capita incomes. Fourth is a high degree of dependence upon agricultural exports. Fifth is high rate of population growth. And the sixth is in many cases a former colonial status. Now we'll discuss the index of primacy. It is the measure of relative importance of the largest town in a nation or a region where index of primacy is equal to P1 upon P2 where P1 is equal to population of the largest town and P2 is the population of the second largest town. There are two sets of issues that have generally been debated by regard to primate city urban system. There are two sets of issues which have been by and large debated with respect to primate city urban system. First is concern with its universal applicability. Second is concern with its desirability or otherwise. Universal applicability. It is not universally pertinent as a rule, but only under definite condition. Prevalent in dual economy or where low level of development is there. To begin with, as a country grows economically, primacy increases. After a definite time, primacy decreases. But Jefferson has not talked about any time factor. In India, Bombay upon Calcutta is 1.1. In Canada, Toronto upon Montreal is 1.1. So high development does not mean low primacy. Desirability. Many think that elevated level of primacy is expression of robust regional disproportional and dearth of development. It has been frequently asserted but not persuasively substantiated that the primate city contributes to regional imbalances and is an disagreeable urban system. With regard to both the issues, the debate is still open to doubt. Nonetheless, primate city urban system do occur in quite a lot of countries of the world and several states of India. The theory fundamental primate city development cannot entirely be disregarded by urban geographers. Indian context. No city in India exercises supremacy over the whole nation. There is no primate city in India at present. The absence of a primate city is partly explained by the large size of the country, its colonial heritage and weaknesses in the forces of nationalism in the country. The absence of a primate city has its root in Indian history. India was never a politically unified nation until 1947. Primate city development is essentially a politically directed process and it takes time to assert itself under conditions of political stability. Further, primate city development at the nation level is characteristic of unitary state with strong central governments. The Constitution of India envisages a partially federal political setup with the state and the union sharing power. This permits the development of national as well as state level primate cities. Primacy at the state level. The first one is West Bengal, where Calcutta upon Asansol is equal to 25.08. In Sikkim, Gangtok upon Singtam is equal to 9.10. In Karnataka, Bangalore upon Hubli is equal to 5.53. In Maharashtra, Mumbai upon Pune is equal to 4.88. In Tamil Nadu, Madras upon Coimbatore is equal to 4.66. In Andhra Pradesh, Hyderabad upon Visakhapatnam is equal to 4.25. And in Gujarat, Ahmedabad upon Surat is equal to 2.75. In Orissa, Cuttack upon Rourkela is equal to 1.02. In Madhya Pradesh, Indore upon Jabalpur is equal to 1.09. In Bihar, Patna upon Dhanbad is equal to 1.35. In Assam, Guwahati upon Dibrugarh is equal to 1.54, where in Uttar Pradesh, Kanpur upon Lucknow is 1.68. In Rajasthan, Jaipur upon Jodhpur is equal to 2.03. Now we'll discuss regional primacy in India. The four largest urban places of India as Mumbai, Kolkata, Delhi and Chennai are located in four regions. Western, Eastern, Northern and Southern region correspondingly. Each state wants the development of its own metropolitan city. In this situation, the regional level primacy subsists in Indian urban system. The four mega cities are the largest in their respective region. In Western region, Mumbai remains the largest city and the second largest city is Ahmedabad. In Northern region, Delhi remained the largest city and Kanpur was the second largest city. In Eastern and Southern region, the second ranked city have changed position. In the Southern region, Hyderabad was the second largest city in 1951, 1961, 1971, while Bangalore failed to notice it in 1981, 1991 and 2001. Kolkata is exhibiting the situation of urban primacy in Eastern region. Till 2001, Kolkata was almost 7 times bigger than the second largest city of Eastern region. At regional level, Kolkata remained a primate city and experienced an increase in primacy level in 2011. It was argued by Ramachandran in 1989 that the case of primacy of Calcutta is even comparable to that of the United Kingdom of other cities of world with primate city characteristics. West Bengal's second largest city, Asansol, was indeed very small in relation to Calcutta. It was 1 upon 25th the size of Calcutta in 1981. Kolkata was established by the colonizer as a strategic location for the administrative, military and business activities. It became the chief reason of primacy of Kolkata. For so many years, it remained the most industrialized metropolis of India, and hence there was a continuous flow of population towards this city. Kolkata merged as the largest city of eastern region. It further produced the agglomerative effect of the whole region. Being the largest urban place of the region, Kolkata became an important city in the term of employment, education, and center of many such opportunities for the migrants. These processes contributed to Kolkata's emergence as a primate city. The high level of primacy of Kolkata show the way to the situation of scarcity of other big towns in the eastern region, and at the same time resulted in the low level of urbanization in eastern India. In fact, it was observed by Ramachandran that in Kolkata's hinterland there are so few towns and cities that one town of at least 20,000 population serve a rural population of 500,000 or more. Kolkata remained the only million plus metropolis in the region until 1981. Each of the three other regions of India, north, west and south, had at least 2 million plus cities in 1981. Kolkata historically got very slight competition from any other city of eastern region because of its economic and administrative importance, and this made Kolkata the largest city of eastern region. The case of Kolkata also explains the relationship between primacy and low level of urbanization in region. Primacy exists in the western region, although comparatively less than that of the eastern region. The level of urbanization in western region is much higher in comparison to the eastern region. Since 1961, there is a slow decline in the primacy of Mumbai in western region. The exception was period 1991, when the primacy value increased, but it decreased again in 2001. This is primarily because of the increased number of size of million plus cities in this region. In western region, Ahmedabad and Pune are the two major million plus cities which are competing with Mumbai. In the southern region, Chennai was never a primate city, although the relative primacy of Chennai has declined after 1981. The other two major cities of this region are giving close competition to Chennai. These cities are Bangalore and Hyderabad. These two cities become very significant in this region because of their importance as IT hub in post-liberalization period. Delhi, in its northern region, is continuously rising as the primate city. It is the only city among the four largest cities whose primacy index has not declined since 1951. Delhi is the capital city of India, and the central government is focusing more for the infrastructure, industrial and overall development of the city. Delhi also has many educational institutions, all these leading to its increasing steps towards primacy. Rank size settlement systems. The concept of rank size settlement system was suggested by G.K. Ziv in 1949. He proposed that if all urban settlement in all areas are arranged in descending order of their population, the population of nth ranking town will be 1 upon n of the largest city. Thus, the population series will be P.P upon 2, P upon 3, P upon n number, where P is equal to population of the largest city, Pn is equal to P1 upon n, where P1 is primate city population, n is equal to rank. Pn is equal to population of nth ranking city. The rank size rule addresses itself to two vital questions. First is why larger settlements are fewer in number, and the second is what is the relationship between larger and smaller settlement. The explanation to both these questions is based on the appreciation of forces of diversification and unification. Forces of diversification. The location of a small settlement is generally determined by nearness to the source of raw material. In such a situation where primary economic activities predominate, land becomes the basic raw material or resource. Land is tilted by farmers to produce food and other basic necessities of life. A present society rooted to the land merges with a large number of village settlements within walking distance of each other. Similarly, apart from agriculture, other primary activities such as mining, fishing and forestry also generate dispersed settlements of a small size at regular interval of distance. As society advances, secondary production makes it possible to locate settlement of greater distances from the sources of raw material. Thus, the settlements specializing in secondary production can be located farther apart and also be larger in terms of population. Nevertheless, a wide range of secondary economic activities must be located near the source of raw materials so that the costs of transportation can be minimized. Secondary economic activity generates settlement of large size and greater distances apart as compared to primary activity. Now we'll discuss about forces of unification. In contrast to the forces of diversification, the forces of unification result in the emergence of few large settlements. Here the focus is on tertiary economic activity. Nearness to the market rather than the source of raw materials is the determining factor in the location of settlement. The size of market is measured by the population of the settlement itself. Thus, a large settlement in itself constitutes a large market. Tertiary activities such as education, health and administration are all consumer oriented and tend to be concentrated in large cities. In recent time, a wide range of secondary activities have acquired a market orientation. For example, electronic and engineering goods and information technology industries. These secondary economic activities also tend to concentrate in large metropolitan cities. These forces lead to the emergence of a few very large cities. Higher degree of primacy suggests the presence of a strong centripetal forces and hence greater tendency towards agglomeration and unification. Absence of primacy suggests the existence of centrifugal forces and their greater tendency towards diversification. A balance between the two forces, which is unification and diversification, could result into creation of an ideal urban system, which is possibly desirable and may be aimed at by the urban planner and policy makers. Rank size rule and application. Ziff studies urban pattern in many countries before propounding this law. It worked better in larger countries like the US and Soviet Union. It also works well in countries with long urban history and in areas that have a more complex social and economic system. Exceptions are where primate cities are there in smaller countries. This pattern could disrupt at least one and two level, example France and Mexico. Second is when one or more of the city size grouping are missing, example Australia. Only big cities are there, no small cities. Canada, only big and small cities, no intermediate one, so the rule will not apply. Rank size rule relationship in India. The rank size relationship is absent in India at the national level as the population size of Mumbai, Kolkata and Delhi is very close to each other. Moreover, a great majority of states in India also do not conform to the rank size rule. In fact, primacy exists in at least 15 out of 29 states of India and is another 8 states, which is Bihar, Kerala, MP, Punjab, Orissa, Goa, Arunachal Pradesh and Nagaland. The leading city is only just larger than the second city. In Kerala, the three cities of Cochin, Calicut and Thiruvananthapuram have nearly the same population size. This is also the case with cities of Indore, Jabalpur, Bhopal in Madhya Pradesh and Ludhiana, Amritsar and Jalandhar in Punjab. Rank size relationship appear to hold good in the state of Rajasthan. In brief, rank size rule in India is an exception rather than a rule. Assessment of the rank size of primate city system. The rank size rule and primate city concept both are empirical construct and their objective is to give explanation of the real world structure of settlement. Although the rank size rule covered the whole settlement system at the same time as the law of primate city focuses only on the leading cities, the rank size rule has lesser empirically legitimacy. In the Indian context, the rank size relationship are exceptions. While primate city characteristics appear to be important in majority of Indian states, the rank size rule is fundamentally economic to a certain extent than a sociological theory of settlement system. The desirability of both is a matter of debate and inconclusively so. On the other hand, both concepts can be constructive to the planner. The rank size rule given by Ziff is considerably unbending and rarely found in an exact empirical fit. Furthermore, it attaches great importance to the population size of the largest city in the region or country. The population size of every other settlement depends on the size of the largest city. The application of rank size rule is difficult because there is no universal definition of city sizes. There are many cities where the built-up area extends outside the administrative boundaries of the city and where many city workers live further than the edge of the built-up areas. Having a look at the problem of application of rank size rule, it can be better used for comparative purposes. The rank size rule is more descriptive rather than explanatory or predictive. Now the postscript. The rank size rule introduced by Ziff and the concept of primate city by Jefferson facilitates in comprehending the distribution of cities and hierarchy in the midst of cities in an urban system. Economic development and an integrated urban system characterizes perfect rank size of cities distribution in the urban system, while the primate city size distribution indicate point toward underdevelopment and disparity, unevenness, inequality in the distribution of cities. When one look at the Indian urban system and the distribution of cities in it, one find that class 1 cities have grown at a higher rate than the small cities. The rank size distribution of cities as introduced by Ziff in 1949, in which the unification process and diversification process have maintained a balance, the Indian urban system was unable to achieve it ever. It pointed out that to a great extent, the large cities of India are on the rise at a faster rate when compared to the small cities. It forbid the small cities to keep to a log linear relationship along with the large cities of Indian urban system. The rank size rule in addition elucidates the size of distribution of settlement with respect to economic activities. Indian urban system show non-presence of rank size rule in the distribution of cities. Therefore, the Indian urban system is much susceptible to the menace of primacy. So far, if one analyzes the Indian urban system, one finds that primacy in India doesn't exist at the national level, but Indian urban system does not remain unaffected by primacy at the regional level. The urban primacy at national level has not been since. At the national level, there are more than one generously proportioned, not only economically but politically important metropolitan cities existing in Indian urban system, namely Mumbai, Chennai, Delhi and Kolkata, recognized as mega cities, basically forbid the concentration of urban population only in one urban center. Following the liberalization period, Pune, Hyderabad and Bangalore have also emerged as other economically significant metropolises. The magnitude of the budding metropolises as major IT hub of India has resulted in the absorption of urban population in these urban centers as well. Therefore, at the national level, not even a single city in India put into effect supremacy over the whole nation. Since, as an outcome of colonial past and the period of liberalization, India has multiple dominant cities of national importance. Consequently, urban population is concentrated in these various noteworthy urban centers rather than restricting to one center only. At the regional level, primacy become apparent since except the southern region, all the three regions confirmed primacy. Kolkata in the eastern region is the archetypal example of primate city. In western region, Mumbai is the primate city. The major reason behind primacy at the regional level is the colonial past of India. When India was a colony under the Britishers, the port cities of Bombay, Calcutta and Madras became not only the leading administrative but also commercial and industrial cities. During the colonial period, these port cities made noteworthy contribution in the maritime trade due to the strategic geographical location. In the year 1911, Delhi once again became the capital of British Indian Empire. It resulted in the development of New Delhi. Delhi in the northern region as a primate city is expanding swiftly. In northern region, one finds that Chennai is the biggest urban center, nonetheless was never the primate city, and for the fact of the matter, relative primacy of Chennai has declined after 1981. In this region, there is no presence of primacy since other cities like Bangalore and Hyderabad experienced swift growth as IT hubs. Chennai, Bangalore and Hyderabad are till today the major cities of southern part. As far as primacy is concerned, India faces a dichotomous situation. Though there is no primacy at national level, which is a good sign, but there is a primacy at the regional level, and that is the sign of unequal urban development. The way forward to deal with primacy is to leave the myopic view of development, wherein the focus is on developing fewer areas due to vested interests. Overall, urban development can only be achieved through sustainable, reflective, and inclusive approach. Thank you.